know they say you can't go home again. I just had to come back one last time. Ma'am, I know you don't know me from Adam.
This house right here. Of all the houses I've toured, watched being built, sold to my clients, or sold for my clients, this house is my favorite. 35 years ago, when I was just a few months old, my parents moved us into this house. They filled it with four daughters, home-cooked meals, discipline, and love. When I was about six, I tried to run away from it after my two older sisters had been picking on me, as older siblings tend to do. "You'll come back," they told me. They were right. We played house and school, made cookies, watched Saturday morning cartoons, painted our nails, built forts, played hide and seek, roller skated in the basement, put on musical performances in our room. It was within its walls I spent hours reading and writing stories, faking naps and singing in the shower. Songs like "Legend of a Cowgirl," "I'm Just a Girl," "One of Us," "Wonderwall," and that godforsaken song from Titanic by Celine Dion. Learning to play the flute and probably annoying my entire family in earshot, talking to my friends on the phone with the cord strung from the wall across the hall into my room, snuggling with my mom in the rocking chair when I was little, and being chased and tickled by Dad. All the bad and all the good along the way, it all happened in the blink of an eye. And then suddenly I was a senior in high school. People told me that when I went to college, I'd miss home, that I'd want to come back. They were right. I came back. A lot. When Mom told me the old house was finally coming down, I had to do one last thing. I went back. I snapped pictures of all the rooms within it, took in the space one last time, and said my mental goodbyes. It looked decrepit, but I could still feel its comfort through the bare walls. Soon, I won't be able to come back to it anymore. But while standing in my childhood room for the last time, I realized something. I've never really left that house. In fact, I've carried it with me for the entire 35 years of my life. Everything it represents, all the memories with the family I was lucky enough to share it with, and all the love and happiness that grew inside its walls are now within me. And though it will be sad knowing I can no longer visit the house I grew up in, I consider myself truly lucky to know the meaning of the word home.
Nothing but a memory from the house that built.